sound the beast.
What are you all dressed up for? Does this lady take pictures for postcards?
We're not dressed up.
You mean you always walk around in all these clothes?
No.
Now, come on, some of them. What's going on here? What is this?
We're having a fair.
Is that milk you're selling there?
Aye.
May I buy some? I'm very thirsty. We've been walking all night. I'll have to see your money first.
What?
What did you give him? A hunk of uranium?
Just a shilling. What a lovely layout this is.
It is very interesting, sir, but I'm afraid it's of no use to me.
What do you mean it's of no use to you? Sell me something and a will be done.
I'm sorry, I can't sell you anything. But if you're thirsty, I can give you a drink.
No, thanks. I don't want any favor.
I see from the coin you're from England.
No, we're from America.
You're an American?
Oh, I am. He's from Brooklyn. Come on, boy.
No, wait. Please, when do they mean to behave so strangely? We're just a wee bit taken aback. People didn't come here very often.
I'm not surprised. You people stare at us as if we'd just dropped in from another world. Is that unusual?
Aye, very much.
Might me.
They say every village has one.
If you've been walking a lot, you must be tired and hungry. Wouldn't I like a bite to eat and perhaps a place to lie down before you start back?
Well, that's very nice of you, thanks.
Good. My name is Fiona.
And I'm Tommy Albright. And this is Jeff Douglas.
How do you do, sir?
And I'm Lynne Brockie.
I'm glad you're happy about it.
There's a wee inn around the corner where you can get some food.
Aye, and I'll take you to it.
You go ahead, I'll be along in a minute. I want to phone the hotel first.
Is Meg going to take care of you, sir?
Well, I'm afraid so. Why?
Well, now, I have some tart and trousers here. And after you leave the inn, if Miss Meg should take you someplace to rest, and you should happen to rip your own on a thistle, I'd be more than pleased to replace them for you.
Oh, thanks, old man, but I don't expect to get stuck.
Then I cannot, lad, if you're stuck now.
Well, you're tending yourself, Mr. Ritchie.